I'm Rob.
And I'm Louie.
And this is Arcade VR Reviewed
by Barefoot Gaming.
I don't know if I'm supposed to pause. There's a hyphen. It's arc hyphen aid.
No, just keep that section of you explaining it to me. And they'll get it.
I will. Good. Louie, Arcade, what is it?
You're freaking Flynn from Tron. You get sucked into the machine, man. It's super cool. And then it's Space Pirate Trainer, which is still really well done and cool.
So we talked about this a little bit in advance, and we don't normally like talk about the reviews too much, so everything is off the cuff. But It does have a very Space Pirate Trainer feeling, except you're not locked to one space.
Yes.
So you have to keep moving around. You've got this great big orb that you need to protect because you're sharing health.
Yep.
Sometimes enemies will just target it, sometimes they'll target you.
Yes.
How do you kill them?
Depending on the enemy, you shoot them to death. Headshots kill them right away, unless they're up armored, and body shots will slowly decrease them over time.
Yep.
And you just kind of push your way through the map, hopefully without your fingers falling off from being too tired. And then you make it to the boss, Rob.
So this is smooth motion locomotion only.
Yes.
Just so you know, but actually it works really, really well. Oftentimes, games that are like a little bit lesser known, we'll find that when we drop in, it's like, some people are gonna get sick with this.
Yeah.
I actually found this was done really, really well. And there's parts where you have to go through liquid, like kind of through digital water, for example.
Yeah. And that particular level, there was a couple little catches where you thought you were kind of binding up against nothing, but you'd look down and there was a tree root that you had to kind of maneuver around. So that's something to pay attention to once you get to the fourth level, I think that was.
Well, and speaking of tree roots, almost everything is fully destructible. So even if it's multiple levels, like you'll have enemies up on a second or third level, like firing at you, or there'll be like a turret.
A giant turret, and you think, I'm gonna duck behind this wall, I'll be protected from it. And all of a sudden the wall starts crumbling down and there's the turret staring at you right in the face.
And it's kind of neat because it uses like not a fog of war, but you can only see a certain distance. And it's kind of like that Tron wall is always there.
Yeah.
So when you move towards it, you can see what's past, right? Yep. So you can shoot different health bonuses, different like your shotguns, your machine guns, different things that'll give you like better ammo or better weapons.
Yep.
But it's not always visible, so you actually have to keep like running around.
Yeah, and you've got to protect the almighty glowy, shaky cube in the sky.
Plus, the enemies are constantly shielding their own stuff.
Yes,
so
especially as you progress through the levels, there will be units that specifically shield other units while they shoot at you, or the Orbeez cube thing.
The Orbeez cube thing.
I don't know what it's called.
So this game goes for, what, 17 US, 20?
Or 25 Canadian, I think.
Yeah, which is a weird spread for some reason. Usually it's not that far off. But whatever the case, pros, cons, Louie, do you recommend this game?
My pros are that it is a really good looking game, and when you watch the gameplay, you'll go, maybe not. But in VR, this looks really, really good. I watched this in 2D first, and it didn't look that great. VR is amazing. It feels really good. The locomotion's great. I highly recommend this. I think the only downside is that it's the same game loop, and once you figure out the boss's big secret, it's the same every time. What about you, Rob?
So, I fell into the same camp. Here's the thing. I get a lot of developers reaching out to me asking if I can review their games. And when they're very unknown, it's a little scary, right? Because I don't want to dump on somebody that's trying really hard to put their stuff out there.
Yep.
And honestly, from the trailers of this game, I'm like, it's got that Tron aesthetic, but I don't really know that this is going to be interesting. Well, we gave it a try, and I was shocked. I was impressed. The game not only looks good, it sounds great. I like the mechanics of the shooting. The way headshots work, not all of the enemies look the same.
Yep.
Yes, your levels will always lay out the same. They are not procedurally generated. That is just the way they are.
Yep.
But you can keep trying to get better times. You can keep trying to get better scores by getting more headshots.
Yep.
And then there's multipliers. So when you're on a roll, you're getting even better.
Yeah. So when I went through the levels, I was just kind of taking my time, making sure I killed everybody because I wasn't sure how the game really played.
Yeah.
Rob played second and he was going through it a lot faster than I was. And I noticed that he was getting his score multiplier up to 9 and I was going like, I didn't even notice the score multiplier, so.
And the only other thing I'm gonna say is don't let the bosses, if you pick this up, don't let the bosses frustrate you.
Yeah.
Because there's almost no instructions in this game to tell you how to play it. It's like you drop in and go.
Yeah.
So there is kind of a little trick. If you get stuck, leave a comment down below and I will spoiler how to actually beat them if you can't figure it out.
Yeah.
But if you can, like it's a good time. Honestly, yeah. this was refreshing. And again, not incredible depth. It has that Space Pirate Trainer-ish feeling that you're just gonna go through and just have a good time for however long until your hand is tired from pulling the trigger a thousand times.
My arm is still tired.
But it's because we kept playing it, so it's fun. And that is a review for
Space Pirate Trainer Tron.
Arcade, with a hyphen in the middle.
Space Pirate Troner.
Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment. We always love hearing from you. If you have any questions, leave them down below. And we will talk to you again really, really soon. See ya.
Bye.